Chair, got the paper machine over here. What's up, Air Todd? How's it going, man? All right, cool. So, this is a metal sign, I guess somebody's making. They brought it to me to kind of paint the colors on. It's a Steelers logo, if you can't tell. So we're gonna do the Steelers colors and candy. We're gonna give this all kind of we're gonna give it a black outline around the edge here. And we're also gonna make it say Steelers. But before I do anything, I'm gonna wipe it off. So it's just bare metal, so we wanna make sure to clean it. Can you hear me good? Is it all right? You should be able to hear me good. Obviously, they were trying to do it themselves, so they had the Steelers kind of written out there, and and they want that Steelers to be in the Rick and Morty colors. The Rick and Morty lettering, I don't know, so that's what we're gonna do. I have the paper machine back here, and I think we're gonna start off by taping up the back and painting these three things here. Just making it easy, quick. Got this all welded up, like pretty cool in the back. It has like support beams for all this and stuff. It's pretty nice. What's up, Stephen Ward? How's it going, man? Hard at work on the Camaro, and you know, now everybody's bringing in Christmas gifts and stuff, so just taking a quick pause from the Camaro, getting these projects done. If you follow me on social media, you've seen the shirts I posted earlier. I got this. We also have some a golf club handle, which I have to put a portrait on. Golf club handle that needs a portrait. I won't bore you guys with that one, though. I'll just do that one in private. This one, though, I know a lot of people take interest in the candy, and I know a lot of guys do or want to do like candy on metal with like scratched metal and stuff like that. So all I did is take the 7800, right? Wipeout surface prep after we got all the metal all, you know, he brought it in all sanded and scraped and stuff. And all we're gonna do is clean it up. So I've done that. And then we're gonna spray candy on it. So we're gonna go color by color here. And let me find the Steelers logo real quick. Green, red, blue. I mean, yellow, red, blue. Oh my god, I said green. So let's see here. Some marine blue already mixed. I'm going to take some blood red. I like blood red. And lemon yellow. I'm out of the tequila, so it will be lemon yellow. It's a nice bright yellow anyway. Looking for my 4050, but it's over here, so perfect. And we're gonna go ahead and mix this up some colors there. So probably start with its top, which is yellow, red, blue. Gotta remind myself I'm not much of a Steelers guy. So let's mix up some yellow. I'm doing good, Steven. I'm doing good. So I'm gonna use 4050 gloss for this, because again, I want those reflections of that scraped metal to shine through. So I'm going to use the gloss for maximum light refraction. God, I always have a hard time figuring the words in that one. So I don't need the whole lot, so I'm only going to mix up a little bit now. Doing the candies, standard mixture, about 5 to 1. A little bit of reducer, help it flow. Yeah, it's like a sign, like a metal wall sign somebody's making for somebody else, like a Christmas gift. It's a Steelers logo sign, and it's a big metal, like a drum kind of thing. And it has these cutouts all kind of made here. Let me turn the pressure down. I was working on t-shirts earlier, so I had to pressure a little bit up. What do I need? Oh, a little piece of tape. And a little piece of paper. You understand. That across there. I'm sure this is mixed up really good. And like I said, I already cleaned it and stuff, so I'm just gonna go ahead and give it a nice even coat. And I'm gonna go ahead and build up that candy on there. I don't wanna just do heavy coats, right? Just like nice and light, let that dry. And actually doing light coats will allow you to lay the candy on there faster as opposed to trying to do heavy coats, because it'll take longer for a heavy coat to dry as opposed to a light coat. So just make sure you build it up on there nice and easy. There, let it dry. And I like this effect. This effect's pretty cool. If I had some extra money, I would definitely go get some metal panels to do some kind of artwork with this. It's like, imagine a portrait, but where all the texture is like done like this. Everybody always just does like these swirls and stuff like that. But what, imagine if you use the artwork, like the strokes as part of the artwork, so that in the end when you put the candy, it kind of gives it all shape and not just color. Yeah, use your noodle. Use your noodle. All right, that's three coats. Let it dry a little longer. Make sure I hit all the edges. Let that dry again. And we'll do one last coat. It's pretty yellow, but we'll do one last kind of heavier coat. And then we'll let it all dry. Now once you've built up a couple layers like that too, and you're just the last coat, you know, you're obviously not gonna sit there and watch it dry. But you can let it dry on its own, and you give it a nice heavy coat at the end. And you know, because that one you're not going to wait for it. So that one will just dry as you're working on other stuff. So there you go. It's really bright yellow. How's it look on camera? It looks pretty yellow. It looks like there's stains on it on camera, but there isn't. Just let that dry while we move on to this bottom. Good job, Mike. That was awesome. Totally missed the edge. There you go. Now load up. up some blue. We'll do the blue on the bottom there. Son, I already have the blue mixed. I guess we're doing red next. Screw it. I don't want to just pour out the 40-50 for no reason. Do a little bit of blood red. See, I poured 40-50 and I already have the blue mixed in, so now I gotta do the red next. The red next. Anyway, how's everybody's weekend? Hope everybody's weekend was good. What's up, James? How's it going? This project probably won't take us all that long. Always make sure you do your edges and stuff like this where people can see the side, you know, make sure you get that side edge. It'll just look at, make it look good. You fixed some mowers and did some painting. Sounds like you're nice and busy, man. That's good. Building up your coats, giving it some air in between, letting it dry, you know. Give it one last coat. It's already pretty red. And when you, the thing about the scraped metal is like when you do this, like when you get the light from different angles, it looks like it's like moving. That's what makes it awesome. That is the awesomeness right there that we're looking for. Push everything to that corner because that's where the trash is right outside. You open the garage and the trash is right there, so I always just pick it up, throw it in the trash. It's the easiest way. What's up, Gary? How's it going, man? You doing good today? You doing good? So good, now let's do the blue. Just some marine blue down here. Bigger compressor. Hey, girlfriend with stockings. Jeez. Pretty specific. He brings you a girlfriend, but she don't have stockings. You're gonna be out of luck, my guy. Let this dry. Brought out those weld marks. You can see the four weld marks from the supports. I wonder if it's just that piece of metal or if it's the blue of blue. Because it's dark, you know? Thank you. So yeah, I'm using the Createx candies with the 4050 direct to metal. Now, I don't know how well this would hold up on a car, so I'm not saying go and do this on a vehicle or something. I honestly haven't done enough testing on my own to do this. But on a sign like this that's going to sit on somebody's walls, never going to be, you know, under any kind of, like, pressure from the wind or a water pressure or anything like that, I have confidence it's going to stay on there. Sorry about all the paper noise. There's nothing I can do about the paper noise. Yeah, the welds showing through. You can see there's like four supports on each one. But the blue one, I guess now that it's really dark, you can't really see it, but when I first did it, you could really tell. So let me get some fine line tape, and I'll lay the fine line tape around here, and we'll do some black candy all the way around. You would think with the etching into the metal, it would give it good tooth. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's kind of why I'm like, yeah, it'll probably be okay. But I don't want to be like, go and do it on your vehicle, because I don't know for sure. I hate saying something if I don't know for sure, you know. I'm just gonna take this tape here. We're gonna lay a line going around, and it's actually, I'll try to make it as straight as I can. But if it's a little bit crooked, I probably will be all right, because I'm not sure how exactly round this thing is. Yeah, for artwork like this, what color blue do you use if you had to do the Bronco, the Cowboys logo? I believe we used to use deep blue for the shirts. Deep blue works pretty good. Deep blue with silver. Can nice star for yourself. I think that looks pretty good, actually. Be all right. Yeah, I could have measured the line. But eyeballing it's not bad either. You got a good eyeball. Not everybody has a good eyeball, but you know. When you got one, you use it. Got it, you got it, man. You don't got it? Well, you gotta try to get it. you made pizza? You suck. Bring me a slice out here. Black candy now. Thank you. Yeah, you should open the garage real quick. Is it cold outside or no?
Yeah.
Yeah? Oh, dang, this looks good.
Violet,
look at
this. Good?
Homemade pizza, look at that.
Violet made it. He goes, I hope you don't get too greasy.
Who said? Your slice is right here. You see, I'm eating this slice, and this slice is for you guys. It's still like hot too. It's good. Good. Now I'm afraid to touch it though because I got grease all over my hands. Perfect. Now we just gotta do the lettering. I'm tempted to be like, that's it for today, so that I could cut that out and then fill it in with the vinyl plotter. Thank you. cool thing about working on metal like this, so if you're gonna run your blade on it, you don't have to worry about so much about scratching it. Obviously, that is the least of your concerns. Let's keep it off of the black there. I'll use the cheap blade since it's already dull. And see here, I got a pen and I got a marker just in case, but try to do it with the pen. Steelers has STEELERS 4 and 4, that's 8. So right in the middle, which is would be probably about right there. That's where I'm gonna say where the middle is. And we'll do about there. But then we need to divide this by 4. That's 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we're going to do the middle here. There. And let me look at this logo real quick. The Rick and Morty logo he sent. So right, he sent this Rick and Morty picture because we're gonna be doing on the sides here. I'm gonna be completely basing it in actual black. And then I'm going to be doing Rick and Morty on the sides here. You know, one on each side, and then it'll just be black with the kind of the green warp effect on the sides here. But it's that none of the scraping and stuff is going to actually show on the sides. That's going to be based, and that's where that's going to go, because this person's a Steelers fan, but also a Rick and Morty fan. But they want the lettering kind of in this Rick and Morty style, which is pretty self-explanatory. I mean, we might as well just... It's kind of like just regular writing, but squiggly. Like edgy squiggly. I don't know, so let's do that. So we're gonna have to have an S. T. E. E. L. E. R. S. Let's try to keep them all about the same height. Some squiggles to it. You know, just make it nice and squiggly. Went too far on that one. Let's keep it up here. The question is, what color should I do this lettering? doing it in green and like the Rick and Morty colors wouldn't make much sense. Should I just do it in black? Should I actually put a color on it so it's the metal part doesn't shine through? Then I could put like some kind of color behind it, like a candy behind it to give it like a glow. I really don't know. But there we have it. Say Steelers. I need to cut that out. Simple enough. So what's everybody's favorite kind of pizza like? What are the toppings? Obviously we all like pepperoni pizza, right? Hopefully. Hopefully one of you is not like vegan. I shouldn't say hopefully, but... pepperoni and jalapenos, that's like usually my favorite. Then I'll put a bunch of Parmesan on it. And I get it. This is also the Make You Hungry stream, just so, just so you guys are aware. Pepperoni, that's it. Like, other than pepperoni, I also like a good spinach pizza. How many of you get down with a spinach pizza with like white cheese? Mmm, son. Somewhere I know there's some, oh, chicken is pretty good too. Yeah, like if you're gonna have like a traditional like pizza pie, chicken with veggies is like bomb for sure. Like if you go to a real Italian restaurant, right, you're gonna order pizza, make sure it's like a chicken with like bell peppers and like onions and stuff. Mmm, son. You're hunting for food now? Mmm. What is a good game out in Australia? Do you guys have deer? Like, I hate to sound freaking ignorant, but do you guys have deer? Like, I don't know much. Man, I would love to go to Australia one day, because I don't know anything about Australia other than y'all got the kangaroos, the koala bears, and the Great Barrier Reef. And I would want to see those three things for sure if I ever visited, but I feel like I would get to see those things without even trying. And what I would really want to know is, like, what else is there, you know? Like, it seems like such a big place, but yet I only know, like, three things about it. Man, if I ever make it big, I'm gonna make sure to set up like classes or like lessons. And I'm gonna use those as an excuse to travel. I'm gonna set up classes in Australia for a month, and then next week I'll be in China. And next, I would definitely. I don't know. Actually, I don't know about China. I don't know if I want to visit China. I feel like I would get lost in China, to be honest with you. I feel like if I got lost, I'd be in big trouble, because I wouldn't know where to go or how to find my way around. I feel like I'd have a better chance in India, because at least I'd match the skin tones, you know? Like, in China, though, I would stick out like a sore thumb. I don't know. Keep getting stuck watching those Indian like street food videos. They look so freaking good. We have deer? Okay, cool. Koala's also a bit harder to find. I would definitely do that. I would definitely like do classes or something somewhere else. Even if it was like for another company, I would definitely do that. Just to be able to meet some of you guys and to travel. And I just got tape all over this. That would be dope. Not gonna lie. Yeah, that's the scary part about going somewhere like that, though, man. If I do love it, then it's gonna be hard to leave, right? Especially if, like, yeah, if I see that there's work that if I could show up and just start airbrushing for people, because either everybody else is slow or slammed, oh, it'd be hard for me to leave, my guy. Especially Australia, like people speak English, right? I don't know. That'd be hard. I know I would probably do a pretty good amount of time there. Alright, so I think I'm just gonna do black candy over this. I think it'll look okay. All the stuff that chases me in bites. I'm good on that one. Snakes don't really bother me that bad. I grew up in an area where there was lots of rattlesnakes. And snakes don't really bother me. Unless they're like super aggressive, which really snakes aren't. Normally you have to get close to them. They don't just like, they're not like cheetahs, you know? They don't actively hunt you anyway. I think that would worry me a little more. Seeing like some kind of crazy animals. go. Steelers. I had to double check the spelling real quick. It looked wrong to me for a second. Alright, and then all I'm gonna do to just make all this kind of set in, and also to bring out some of this kind of effect, the scrape effect, is I'm just gonna give it some 40-50 gloss over the whole thing. And that'll just pretty much seal it in and everything. And yeah. So the only thing I might do later on is once I'm done with the sides and everything, I might just come back and add a little pinstripe, probably like a white pinstripe or something, going around the letters once we have everything all finished. And that'll really make the letters pop. But for, as it is, I think that's pretty good for now. Like all I'm gonna do now, like I said, 40-50 over the whole thing. Brown snakes will chase you? Fuck that. Oh, poor dog. Sorry, dog. I didn't mean to tease. So this 40-50 will just act like as a protectant until I lay on the 2K clear once I'm completely done with everything. But it'll stop any, you know, moisture or anything to getting from the metal, so we don't have any kind of rust spots starting to develop or anything like that. And when we lay the clear, also this 40-50 will kind of set into those cracks a little bit. It's already kind of making the effect a lot stronger of when you move. And I'll move it here in a second for you guys so you guys can see that too. But let me just finish laying on this and I'll show you guys what I mean by it kind of moves. When you do this, you're like moving side to side going, whoa! You look silly doing it, but the artwork looks amazing. So,
good. I think we got it pretty even.
Give you guys a quick look-see. Quick look-see, Daisy. So there you can see kind of what I mean. Trying to find the right light angle. There you go. It's hard to like hold it in place and look at the TV and do it. It's pretty straight. Yeah, looks pretty good. Let that dry up. I'll come back tomorrow. We'll do the Rick and Morty's on the side. Obviously, I'm probably not going to stream that. I'll just do that on my own time. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoy that. And enjoy the rest of, or enjoy the start of your week. And we'll be back on Thursday to kind of go over another how-to. We'll be doing some artwork though. This is just a project that came in, and I thought it'd be a good idea for a video to show you guys kind of how to lay that candy, or show you guys how that candy lays over bare scraped metal like that. You can really see it with the light. It's really hard with the camera because the camera catches the glare like that. In real life, you don't catch a glare like that, so it's a lot darker in real life. But you get the idea. And we'll see you guys next time. Thank you guys all for watching. Thank you, Stephen Ward, for keeping me company in the chat. Pineapple or barbecue pizza? Sometimes just cheese. Cheese pizza is good. I don't know about barbecue pizza, Eric Todd. I don't know about barbecue pizza, man. You got me sideways on that one. I have to try it. I don't know. Maybe you got a good place that makes good barbecue pizza. but yeah. I'll go ahead and let you guys go. Have a good night, everybody. Thank you guys, everybody, for stopping in. Right on, Gary's. Thank you for stopping in. As always, thank you to all you guys for being part of the Skull Squad. Thank you to Createx right up here for providing the candy and paint for today's channel. For today's video. Yeah, shout out to Createx for providing the paint for today's video. Super Clean for providing the cleaning materials for cleaning my airbrushes and stuff. And shout out to all you guys for being part of the Skull Squad and helping bring more videos like this. It all helps. It all culminates into this one amazing experience of us. So yeah, as always, enjoy the beginning of your week. We'll be back Thursday, and I'll put up a poll come Tuesday so you guys can choose what you want to do on Thursday. So, yeah, we'll see you guys next time. Later.